Hi, I'm Ashmi and welcome to my channel Honey Chili Stories. Students all over the world come to Belgium for bachelor's, master's, PhD because Belgium has some of the topmost universities in the world and they provide a very high quality education. So I've made a detailed video explaining the process of admission, the tuition fees, student visa for international students who plan to come to Belgium for the education. So definitely check that video, it will surely help you. So coming to the topic of this video, as soon as the students start studying in any Belgian university, they start looking for part-time jobs because let me tell you, living in this country can get expensive and doing part-time jobs can definitely help students to cover their monthly expenses to some extent. But before diving into all the things related to the part-time jobs for students, I want to quickly brief you regarding the cost of living. So the main cost of living for students is the accommodation. So if a student choose the university halls of residence, which are the rooms available in the campus of their university, then it is usually between 200 to 400 euros or 450 euros. But if a student does not want to live in the rooms of campus of university, then he or she can rent an apartment and share with other students. For example, a one bedroom apartment can be shared between two students and that is usually around 400 to 450 euros. And that does not include the utility bills actually, which is electricity, the food, water, heating. So total per student can cost up to 500 to 550 euros per month. So the third option is homestay. So many people rent out one of the rooms in their own apartment to students and one meal per day is also included in that. So such homestays can be little expensive and can cost between 400 to 600 euros. Then if a student comes to Belgium with their partner or a spouse and if they have children, then they have to rent out one or two bedroom apartment and that is usually between 600 to 800 euros excluding the utility. The utility costs up to 150 euros per month and can get little more or little less depending upon the usage. So then other than accommodation, there are other expenses like food, travel, grocery shopping. So on average, the students have to spend around 750 to 1000 or 1100 euros per month. So that is the cost of living for students. So to cover the monthly expenses of approximately 1000 euros, part-time jobs can play a very big part. So the first question is, can international students do part-time job in Belgium? So the answer is yes. Basically, all students studying in college full-time and those who are registered with the full curriculum of their course in Belgian university become eligible to do the part-time jobs. Also, when international students come to Belgium, they get residence permit card and that allows them to do the part-time job. So till the validity of the residence permit, they can do the part-time job and even the full-time job post the completion of their graduation. But if some students are waiting for their residence permit and they have Annex 15, then that can also be used as a substitute to do part-time jobs in Belgium. Also, you should know that previously for doing any temporary jobs in Belgium, visa type C was required, but that rule has been changed recently and that visa is not required anymore. The residence permit card issued for the non-European students will therefore contain the information regarding the eligibility to work in Belgium at the back of their card. Now the second question is, who cannot do the part-time jobs? So first are the employees who are students. So that means the employees who are actually working in any particular company, but they are also doing studies. That means their primary status is not full-time student and they are not eligible to do part-time jobs. This also applies for employees who are on leave without pay or are on career break and so on. They are not allowed to do the part-time jobs. The second category is the job seekers who are entitled to the job seekers allowance. Third category is the doctoral students with scholarship. So there are many PhD students who have enrolled in the Belgian university through scholarship. Even they are not allowed to do part-time jobs in Belgium. Then the doctoral students who are employed. So I have explained in the previous video where PhD students are actually not standard students but are employees of Belgian university where they are teaching assistants or researcher and they get salary per month. So they are also not allowed to do part-time jobs. Then there are students without legal residence. And lastly, students who are undergoing asylum procedure, awaiting asylum, even they cannot do the part-time jobs in Belgium. So these were the list of categories of students who are not allowed to do part-time jobs. But it is also important to know that students cannot do part-time job before their college starts. For example, you are enrolled in summer semester when your college starts for the first time and you come to Belgium 1 or 2 months before the college starts. That does not mean that because you have spare time, you can start doing part-time jobs. You can do that only after the start of your academic year. The third question is it important to know the local language to get any part-time job in Belgium? So the obvious answer is yes. Now Belgium has three official languages, Dutch, French and German, and English is actually the fourth language. So you have to know the basics of Dutch or French depending upon the region of your university. So if you're in the Flanders part of the country, you should know Dutch. And if you're in the Wallonia part of the country, you should know French. But that does not mean that all the jobs have the language requirement. Some jobs might just need English. But to find such jobs, you have to have patience and it might take time to find them. So I saw someone posted on Quora for the English related language jobs. Like you can be the babysitter for an expat family, or you can be the babysitter for a Belgian family where they want the children to learn English. You can be a waitress in any of the Irish pubs. Then there are also jobs like cleaning jobs or ironing the clothes of some cleaning housing agencies where actually speaking is not required. Then maybe working in a fast food franchisee in the center of the city. But I don't think the local language requirement should be a barrier for students, because if you are coming to Belgian university in the first place, chances are higher that your course is in Dutch or French, so you anyways have to learn the language, and that eventually will help you in finding part-time jobs in Belgium. Now the fourth question is, how many hours the students can work in the part-time jobs? So first of all, students are not supposed to skip on their classes or the activities related to their study program. Like part-time job should not affect the studies of any student. So coming to the hours, international students can work up to 20 hours per week. That means a maximum of 80 hours per month. Students have the contingent of 475 hours per academic year, for which they owe a limited solidarity contributions. So I will talk about it in a bit. Now, if you work for more than stipulated number of hours, that means the main reason of your coming to Belgium is no longer schooling but work. So this could cause a problem to your employer, as well as when you want to renew your residence permit. So it is very important for students not to do overtime. However, during official holidays, like during the winter, spring, summer, the limitation is not there. So students can work for more than 20 hours per week. Now I mentioned about the 475 hours per academic year earlier. So what is that? The government gives the package of 475 hours for student as their quota. And the students can work for this 475 hours without paying the social security contribution, but a very minimal solidarity contribution, which is very less. Like it is around 2.71% for students and it is around 5.42% for the employer. Now to get this 475 hours, the students have to register themselves at student@work website. So student work is a form of work where, as a student, you are protected by a kind of specific contract, the student employment contract, and this is the fixed term contract. So as a student jobstee with the student contract, you are protected by the labor legislation. This determines the type of work authorized, how many days off you are entitled to, when can you work and not, etc. But you should also know that you are allowed to work for more than 475 hours, but then the social security contribution will be higher starting from the 476th hour. Also, you are not obliged to use the 475 hours, so in consultation with your employer, you can decide whether to use the 475 hours or not. So all that has to be mentioned in the student contract which you receive from the employer. So if you have any confusion regarding the hours and the concept, then don't worry, because I have added all the links in the description box below. So definitely check those links and that will help you to clarify all your doubts. Now next question is, where to find such jobs and how to find such jobs. So first let me tell you about the JOS, or I'll pronounce it JOS, I'm not sure. So JOS is an innovative project run by the student facilities of the Flemish and the Brussels University College in collaboration with the Flemish Public Employment and the Vocational Training Service, also called VDAB. So you can contact the Office for Student Affairs and understand how to get into the system. Here, you can find all the job openings posted by the participating university colleges and universities, as well as the job openings for students workers published by companies or by the VDAB. There is a varied selection of jobs available during both the academic year and the holiday months. You can easily search the jobs which match your criteria in JOS regardless of where you live and study. The database allows you to do targeted search based on your profession, your sector, and also the region where you want to work. In JOS, you can also find the template for the student employment contract. So I have added the link for JOS in the description box below. Definitely check that out. Apart from JOS, you can also register yourself at various temporary work agencies. So I've made a list of the various agencies in the description box below. Then of course, everyone knows about LinkedIn, Indeed.com, where you can filter out the job options for English speaking jobs. Then apart from that, there are a few websites specific to regions of Belgium. So for all the cities of Belgium, you can check on www.student.be. For jobs in Brussels, you can check www.actiris.be. And for jobs in the Wallonia part of the country, you can check www.leforum.be. In addition, there are jobs in restaurants, in cafes, a grocery store, in clothing stores. For example, you can work in clothing store like in Primark or in some grocery store for managing the packages. You can also do the job of delivering food to various customers through takeaway.com or delivery.be. And for on-campus jobs, you can check for job openings in the university portals and check if there is any vacancy. But mostly such on-campus jobs are given to the local students and not international students because of the high skill language requirement. But still, you can check it out. There is no harm, and if you're lucky, you might get an on-campus job. Also, you can check for freelancing online jobs like web designing, graphic designing, writing, social media management, digital marketing, and so on. So if you have the skills, you can use such skills to do part-time job. Make sure you have a very clear resume mentioning all your volunteering work, your previous jobs, and as well as your studies. So you can find tips and tricks online how to make a good resume to apply for such part-time jobs. Now coming to the final question, it is how much students can earn per hour and if they have to pay any taxes based on this part-time job. So on average in Belgium, it is around 10 to 12 euros per hour that a student can earn doing the part-time jobs. And it is a really good amount per hour because, for example, you are working for 80 hours a month and the rate per hour is 10 euros. So you are earning 800 euros per month, and that can easily cover your monthly expenses. And some students can earn even more, like more than 1000 euros per month. So that depends upon the job they do. So you can check all the options where you can earn such good amount doing just part-time jobs. And regarding the taxation, it depends upon how much you earn in your part-time job. If you earn less than the required amount, then you do not have to pay any tax. The maximum amount changes per year. The amount for 2021 is 12,930 euros. This is the gross amount after the deduction of social security contribution. So this is all the information that I could share regarding the cost of living and the part-time jobs for students, and I hope this video helped you, and I've added all the important links in the description box below, so definitely check that out. Also, I will request you to put your valuable feedback in the comment section below along with the topics you want me to make videos in future regarding Belgium. If you found this video useful, then please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.